It's not polite to just laugh at somebody when they look at you. Like, how would you feel if I saw you and I went, oh, although, no. Do I look different to you? Because I feel different. No, I did something I don't normally do this weekend. Guess what I did? All right, I'll tell you. I went to a party, a Hollywood party full of exciting celebrities and Don Rickles. I'm kidding, Don, I'm kidding. You see, now, if you know anything about me, which of course you think you do, but you don't, I love Don Rickles and his wife, Barbara. Not necessarily in that order. But I go to this party and Don was there and he is... Do you know the thing that people don't know about Don Rickles is how he smells? He smells... If you can imagine, if you have a dream where you walk through an enchanted forest and a pixie comes up with a lovely little bouquet of roses and says, "Hello, I'm the pixie of good smelly things." And put the pixie of roses under your nose and you inhale that, that's nothing like what Don smells. he smells fine. Anyway, it was very exciting for me because Don Rickles is there and Gary Shandling was there. Aha! And I was thinking, these comedy giants, and both of them said, "Who are you?" But I had the last laugh. I didn't really. Here's the thing. I'm very excited because if you know anything about this show, which of course you do, or you don't, and that's why you're watching. But Jeffrey Peterson, the robot skeleton, has been upgraded, and we're very excited to see what he can do. I personally think he might drop his pants. I think he might. We'll be right back. Sit down and relax. I am very glad. Please. I'm very glad you're such a good audience. I really am, because we have a particularly weak show tonight. And we're going to need all the help we can get. I'm not kidding. All right, you know that, you've seen us before. It's a great day for America, everybody, yes it is. Yeah, it is. It is a great day. But what's that? That's not clapping. This is not clapping. That's passive aggressive hand movement. Oh, get on with it. It is a great day for America, but not a great day in the Gulf of Mexico, because there are rumors that the containment cap that they put on is starting to leak. And when asked if the rumors were true, a BP spokesperson said, "Aren't there any more Mel Gibson tapes?" Because that guy's awful, isn't he awful? Pay no attention to this oil spill. What about this guy here? There are reports that Mel Gibson is moving back to Australia, and Australians are not that happy about it. They're like, what do you think we sent him to you in the first place? And if he does go to Australia, he better be careful, because a kangaroo will punch you back. There's also big news from Broadway. Andrew Lloyd Webber is working on a new Wizard of Oz musical. The idea came to him when he watched the original film and he said, I think I can make this gayer.
Oh my.
Oh my is right, Jeff. The cast of the Jersey Shore are on strike. They say they're not being paid enough for... What did he do? Anyway, their demands are... their demands are more money, more time off, and a health plan that covers fake boobies. I'm not sure what the women want, but that's what they... Apparently that's what young women want now, is somebody that does this for most of the day.
That's just wrong.
Is it, Jeffrey? I wouldn't judge. I think maybe that's what... well, it's... Did you just nod your head at me? Oh, I see. You shook your head at me. Oh, someone's showing off their upgrade.
Anyway, Greg, I'm a new man.
Yeah. Too. Be careful. You get too good, I'm out of a job.
Right.
Hey! The hell? Well, it's making the crew laugh, so that's something. Look, there was an interview with Hugh Hefner, who looks a bit like Jeff. Was it Hugh Hefner? Said in this interview that fake breasts will never go out of style. Then he said the same thing about record players, poodle skirts, and asbestos. Look, I'm not in on the joke either, all right? Anyway, I tell you why it's a great day for America. I eventually will tell you why, because it's a great day if you love ice cream. And who doesn't love ice cream? Well, Al-Qaeda, obviously. I cannot abide your ice cream. I hate your ice cream and your puppet regime in Pakistan. But mostly ice cream. Anyway, July is National Ice Cream Month. Do we have a graphic for Ice Cream Month quickly? It's Ice Cream Month, and yesterday was National Ice Cream Day. It's a real day. It was started by Ronald Reagan in 1984. It's not on a fixed day. It rotates, but usually it's the third Sunday in July. Reagan was a genius, you see. He kept the commies guessing about what date the Americans... what date the Americans would go crazy licking cream-covered nuts. Anyway, I like my ice cream like I like my sex, alone in front of the television. Now, I actually prefer going out for ice cream. I don't like keeping it in the house because it's too tempting when it's in the freezer. I can hear it calling me, cream, eat me, I'm delicious. Actually, it sounds just like my pool boy. Because apparently my pool boy is also a ghost from Scotland. I'll just clean your pool. I know nothing about pool cleanliness. For where I once lived, there were no swimming pools. Anyway, here's the thing, though. Like, yesterday's National Ice Cream Day. It's Ice Cream Month, right, the whole of July. And today, Baskin-Robbins celebrate by retiring five flavors. Ah, that stopped your inappropriately amounts of laughter, didn't it? Think five Baskin-Robbins flavors, gone. It seems an odd way to celebrate. It's like celebrating Arbor Day by starting a forest fire. When I heard that Baskin-Robbins was retiring the flavors, I assumed, well, it'll be the crap ones, you know, chocolate lint or No, those ones, gravel road and all that. Anyway, they're retiring, get this, French vanilla. Exactly. I'm like, can they do that? Can you retire French vanilla just because it's old and unpopular with the kids? I mean, what's next? I'm not sure what the difference is between vanilla and French vanilla. I think that with French vanilla, you have to use your tongue more.
Oh, my.
I prefer Greek yogurt myself. Is there anything he can't say? Apparently, we've reached the end of the upgrades.
It's Tootsie Fruitsy break time.
Oh, well, apparently not. It's Tootsie Fruitsy break time. No way are we that polished. Like, if he said that and then I went, oh, it's Tootsie, then that would be great. But I tell you one thing, as long as I'm on this show, it will never be great. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the show. What time is it, Jeff Peterson?
Hey, Fergermeister, tweets and emails.
Why not? Twitter. Tweet, tweet, tweet. Twitter. Chicken Vindaloo is good to eat. My name is Scooter. I'll fix your computer. I'm a happening guy and a dope troubleshooter. When you call tech support, you'll be talking to me. I got more patience than Mahatma Gandhi. And emails.
And emails!
Right, come on then. Let's get on with it. We can't be mucking around. We got a lot to do, a lot of emails. What? The doorbell? Who could that be? What? Why, it's Grant Imahara from the Mythbusters. Hello, Grant.
Hi, Craig.
Grant!
All right.
What a surprise to see you. Right on time. Grant, if you don't know, is the inventor and creator of Jeff Peterson, the robot skeleton. And, yeah.
Thank you.
You've been doing some upgrades on him.
I have. He's got all new moves to show you.
When did you install the wise-ass chip that he was using?
It's always been there. I just activated it.
My God. Yeah. Listen, I went on the Tweety today and I said that you were going to be here for the tweets and the emails, and then I forgot, and then the doorbell went, and then I remembered. And... and I asked people to tweet or email questions in that they could ask you about science and stuff.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, I know.
Okay.
So here's one. This is pretty easy, though. This is from Warren in Cambridge in Massachusetts. They, that's very near Boston.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It is.
You'll be all right there.
All right.
All right. Dear Grant, he says, would you please explain why you could expect a BEF2 molecule to be linear but an SF2 molecule to be angular?
Oh.
People are crazy, aren't they?
Obviously.
Yeah. All right.
Okay, one down.
No, I need you to explain why the SF2 molecule would be angular.
Right, well, you know, an angular orientation is...
All right, I'm kidding.
Thank you.
Yeah, all right. See how it feels now?
Yeah.
All right, this is from Doug from Huntington in New York. It's also to you, though. Is there anything to me?
That's a picture of something.
That's an owl. Well, what we do is, this is very science-based, but we have, when we have tweets, we put pictures of birds on them so that I will know that it's a tweet.
Okay.
I was in Atlantic City like last week, 2 weeks ago, and I wanted to get something to eat. I was with my 9-year-old son, and we went into a Hooters. And
hey, there's no tweets there.
No, but my son said, "Why are we going in here?" And I said, "Cause we like owls."
Yes. Yes, they have owls on their shirts, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think.
All right, this is from Doug in Huntington in New York. He said, Grant, that's for you, all right. I thought Isaac Asimov invented the term robot, but my friend tells me it was a playwright from Czechoslovakia named Karl Kapek. Oh, Kapek, is that right?
I believe that's true. Yes, that is true. I got one. Thank you.
That's pretty good. So you've got, a master's degree in robots?
Some would say a PhD, but...
A PhD in...
I have a bachelor's degree in electrical engineering.
Right. And that's it?
That's it. And a lot of experience.
Yeah, all right. All right, here's the tweet with the owl on it.
Okay, got it.
You want to try that on Mythbusters?
Yeah.
Get an owl and check to see if the myth that they're really scantily clad young woman.
I will pitch that.
Yeah, Adam will be fine with that.
Yeah, I think so.
All right, this is from Anthony in Santa Rosa in California. He says, Dear Craig and Grant, look, you knew you were coming.
Okay, good, yeah, there you go.
He says, Dear Craig and Grant, do androids dream of electric sheep?
Oh.
That's good. Now, what's that from, Grant?
That's a Blade Runner reference.
Blade Runner reference from, who wrote it? Was it Philip K. Dick who wrote the...
I believe it was.
Philip K. Dick who wrote the story, Do Androids Dream of Electric Sheep? And then that was adapted into the movie Blade Runner.
That's it.
Oh, man, I'm much more of a geek than I let on.
Yeah. You just let it all slip right there.
I completely unloaded my inner Doctor Who just fell out. Yeah.
Oops, there it is.
There it is.
That's right. Comic-Con is next week.
Yeah, you go to Comic-Con?
Week.
You go to Comic-Con?
Yeah.
Jeff's going down,
anybody?
I believe. Yeah.
That's right. Jeff's going too.
Yeah. All right, that's enough. Comic-Con in San Diego.
Yeah.
Do you party when you go down there?
Well, I've been known to, celebrate.
You're kind of like, if you don't mind me saying so, you're kind of like the Keith Richards of robotics, aren't you? You're kind of like
The edgy,
crazy, I'll just try one more crazy emoticon chip in here.
Somebody has to push the envelope.
You're the one, I'm telling you, you're the one in the movie in the first 10 or 15 minutes says, I'll just try the emoticon chip for a moment, and then all hell breaks loose, and you're the first one to die. Oh, this is an interesting question. This is from Jessica in Nashville in Tennessee, which raises a lot of questions, this question, actually, who says, Dear Craig and Grant, probably means it the other way around.
Yeah.
any plans to build Jeff a lady friend?
Oh.
Ooh, well, we've got some news.
Yeah. not currently. Not officially. How about that?
Well, the thing is, Jeff is from San Francisco.
Oh, my.
You're right.
I didn't program him, any specific way.
You mean you didn't program any sexuality into the robot?
No, not yet.
I think he's been left next to a radioactive copy of The Wizard of Oz or something then, because clearly something has affected his circuits in a very fabulous way.
Well, then maybe we'll be building him another type of friend.
Well, or you could build him a lady friend he could go shopping with.
They could be best buds.
I love this job.
Yeah. I don't care if you don't like us. This is awesome to me. Isn't that awesome?
Yeah, that's awesome. Great.
Yeah. Oh, we're out of time. I'm sorry, Grant. Jeff, you're going to be here. Yeah. So, we have to very quickly. So, you're going to Comic-Con, right?
Yep.
When's the Mythbusters panel? Is that Saturday night?
It's on Saturday night.
Right. Okay. And you'll all be there.
We will all five be there for the first time.
Right. That's very exciting. And yep. Chris Hardwick's going to.
Yes, he's going to moderate our panel discussion.
He's a very funny young man. Chris
he's good.
Hardwick.
He's great.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes. I'm very. I watch him carefully.
Yeah.
Ooh. Oh, yeah.
Yes.
See what I'm saying? Yes. Yeah, because there can be only one.
Yeah.
Another geek round, yeah.
You want to go.
Grant Imahara, everybody. We'll be right back. Welcome back, everybody. My next guest is my first guest. There's a guest coming out now, in no particular order, except he's first official. Oh, ooh la la. I don't know. Look, here's a guy who's in a movie called The Losers, which is available now on DVD. Take a look at this. Tells you everything you need to know about why the Oscars suck. Because you'll never see a movie like that up for an Oscar. But yet, will you go? Yes, of course. Nobody in that movie says, I say, Lord Percy, I'm having a very difficult time. Therefore, no Oscar. However, awesomeness. Please welcome awesomeness, Jeffrey Dean Morgan, everybody.
Really well, how are you?
Yeah, I'm good. Yeah. I'm looking forward to it. Can I take this?
You can have it.
Yeah,
it's yours.
Look, who's that there with the holding the gun, that young lady?
That's Zoe Saldana.
Hey, she's a fine-looking young woman,
isn't
she?
Yeah, yeah, she was the blue chick in Avatar.
Yeah, that's right. Hey, we don't say blue chick.
Is that kind of Mel Gibson of me?
Yeah, a little bit. We say blue American.
Blue American. Yeah. Blue American.
Well, she wasn't American, though. She was Avatarian.
Yeah.
What was the name of that planet again?
I don't remember.
Didn't you see that movie?
I did, but I don't remember the name of the planet.
No, not that. What was it called? Pandora. Pandora.
She was a blue Pandorian.
She was a Pandoranian.
That's exactly right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You ever painted yourself blue? Have you ever seen the Blue Man Group?
I have seen the Blue Man Group.
Pretty exciting.
Sort of awesome.
Yeah.
It's got that kind of blue latexy paint, which... it oddly, kind of turns me on in a weird way. I know.
Where did you see them? Las Vegas or in New York?
Some in New York.
Yeah, because if you see them in Las Vegas, it's a different thing.
Not blue latexy?
Oh, yeah, but they give you lap dances.
I got to go to Vegas now.
The Blue Man Group come out and they go, dum, 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 dum. Like two of them go, dum, 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 and one of them goes, dum, 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 dum. They
that's
don't, awesome. But that would be fantastic,
that's a
actually.
Whole
yeah.
Thing.
Yeah. You've been to Vegas?
Not recently.
I think a road trip.
Let's do it.
Hey.
Because I thought maybe I'd outgrown Vegas, but I think with you, that's
See?
Yeah.
Well, the thing is, I think that I'm going to have a good time when I go, and then I go and I go, oh, well, I got to go to my room. It's 10 o'clock.
Well, that's it. Things were different, like, a long time ago. Like, say, 20 years ago, and you'd be up for 2 days straight, and or I would be. I'm not going to project.
Yeah, a little
but
bit.
But now it's really like, oh, God, I want to see, you know, I want to wake up in the morning.
I want to wake up in the morning. I get excited. This is how old I am now, right? So before I go to bed sometimes, I get excited about breakfast.
I know that feeling.
Like, I'm like, ooh, I'm going to have toast.
No, you can smell the coffee and the sausages as you... Oh, it's
I'm
very
excited
exciting.
Now.
I know.
I'm excited now.
I might have breakfast for dinner tonight.
I do love breakfast.
I do, too.
I don't know what it is. I think since my scrotum completely collapsed... breakfast is my only consolation. Well, there goes my balls. Have my breakfast.
Oh, my scrotum's in the same place yours is.
Can I give you a tip?
Sure.
A roller skate. One roller skate with some kind of cushion, and then you'll
you're good to go.
Oh, You move around.
You're good
it's
to
awesome.
Go. Redesign the pants somehow to yeah. to make the roller
Try
skate
make
work.
Make that movement like you're on rollerblades.
God, that's awesome. That is really, really great.
Yeah, whatever. Hey, no, Tootsie Fruits. You're a pop now, of course, aren't you?
I am.
That's very exciting.
A 4-month-old boy.
Well, see, yeah.
Who's so, probably watching this right now. Gus, go to sleep. He watches TV, man. He really likes your program.
How about that for appealing to the younger demographic?
See?
Yeah.
It's awesome.
Yeah, no. We're saying awesome quite a lot.
I know. It's my word today.
It is awesome.
You know, it's awesome. It's a lack of sleep.
Yeah.
My vocabulary goes to
nobody
crap.
Nobody told me that. When I became a father, nobody told me about the lack of sleep. They might have said, as well said, you know, remember that time you got into speed in the 80s? It's like that.
Yeah. It is, and I've been working and hauling my family to New Orleans, and now we're upstate New York, and I've been
upstate
working.
Upstate New York's nice, though.
It's beautiful.
So is New Orleans.
New Orleans is super hot, and I was in the swamps. But New Orleans itself is beautiful. But it was that's a hard place to be. I didn't take my kid out to the swamps, but I should have.
I've been there.
Yeah.
I've been to the swamps. Yeah.
You're not messing around.
No, they got. Alligators, call them gators. Yeah.
And water moccasins.
Water moccasins.
Man, yeah. And
that's a snake.
Yeah. And I was like, I spent a good portion of a couple days like this deep in swamp water at night, and you could see alligator eyes in the distance. And
were you making a movie or just go there for fun?
Just hanging out.
Yeah.
Just wanted to experience some stuff.
Yeah.
But these things called chiggers. They embed yourself.
People love them.
Oh.
People went, chiggers.
Okay, well, no one
Don't
told me.
Don't mention the chiggers. Stay on the path.
Chiggers. Chiggers in my nether region.
To explain.
Okay, they're like little creatures that burrow in your skin, and they're like the size of a pinhead. And they burrow in your skin, and so
what do they do when
they
get
wherever
there?
There's like kind of friction going on, like where I had my underwear on, obviously, and my socks and shoes. So I had chiggers, bleh, and chiggers, bleh. And
oh, you had bleh, bleh. Like bleh and bleh. Yeah, you get
good,
special
right?
Big chiggers.
Huge chiggers. So that, and I don't know how that tied into the story with my kid, but.
Hey, it was awesome.
It was awesome.
Yeah. We're out of time.
No, we're not.
Yeah, no, it's crazy.
I just got here.
I know.
I flew all the way from New York to come and see you, and this is it. Well, we should do another segment.
We do. All right, then.
There you go.
Well, the only trouble, I've got another guest. I'd have to explain to her.
Who is it?
Mary Lynn.
Oh, Mary Lynn Rajskub.
Mary Lynn Rajskub.
She's on the 24 show.
Yeah.
You know, she's outstanding. I won't do that to her. Bring her out.
Well, why don't you sit on the... We never use the second chair. You could sit there.
I would totally do that.
But don't do anything dumb to upset our segment. She's never been here before, and I'd quite like to impress her.
Okay. All right. No, so I'll just be quiet.
Right, just be
it'll
quiet. Just be,
it'll be me and Jeff... And by the way, Jeff Peterson's 2.0 upgrade from the back room when I was watching him, it looks like he's pleasuring himself.
Yeah. I know.
That's an awesome upgrade.
It is. All right, we'll be right back with Mary Lynn Rajskub. Shut up and don't embarrass me.
Okay.
My buddy Jeffrey's been awkward. But luckily now we have a fantastic guest, a beautiful actress and comedian. She has a one-woman show called Mary Lynn Spreads Her Legs. It's at the Steve Allen Theater in Los Angeles. Please welcome Mary Lynn Rajskub, everyone. Mary Lynn Rajskub. Hello, Mary Lynn. How are you?
I'm okay. just want to know what's going on out here.
No, it's nothing weird. It's just that Jeffrey came all the way from New York, and mm-hmm. I haven't seen him for a while, and we're both very big fans of yours.
Huge fans.
You are? Yeah, oh, yeah. I love that.
And we really were wondering if, you know that show Marilyn Spreads Her Legs? We were wondering what happens there.
Like, really wondering.
But see, Jeffrey, when he heard out that the show was called that, he wouldn't go.
It's a pretty provocative title.
Yeah,
I'll give you that.
A little bit.
It's about gardening.
Ah.
I'm kidding. It is about me spreading my legs.
Perhaps gardening needs to be done.
But guys, be cool. I mean.
That was bad, right?
You mean gardening of the.
That's what I thought you were going.
Weird.
I'm gonna go over with Jeff Peterson.
That's just wrong.
Yeah. No, we're good. No.
I actually don't believe in. Never mind. No, I mean I do, but I wasn't brought up that way. And
well, no one's brought up that way. No one says, "Come on, get your pubes waxed."
I know.
It's just people pick up on it later.
Yeah, and like even in LA, it seems like people do the whole thing.
Well, you know, you have to pay in advance. You have to pay in advance.
Right. Let's change the subject.
All right.
Anyway, about those chiggers that you were talking about.
No, yeah. Have you ever had chiggers?
No. Let's change the subject.
All right.
About ice cream.
It's National Ice Cream Day yesterday.
Happy National Ice Cream Day.
Happy National Ice Cream Day.
You too.
And also Rajskub. With you.
That's an interesting name. Is that Dutch?
Czechoslovakian.
Oh, nice. Have you ever been to Czechoslovakia?
I have. I've been to Prague. It's pretty amazing.
Nice.
Place.
It's a very pleasant place. Have you ever enjoyed their Budweiser?
I probably have.
They have. The original Budweiser was from Czechoslovakia. I know about beer because it nearly killed me.
I'm glad it didn't.
I'm sometimes glad it didn't. Most times.
I hear you.
So your show is about...
That's what we're talking about.
That's about having a baby?
It's about all the things that can happen when you spread your legs before, after, and... Yes, it's about me having a baby.
Well, I think we have to see this. I'm up for it. You want to go see it with me, Jeffrey?
I do. Yeah? Chiggers can happen if you spread your legs.
Yeah.
Bet that's not in your movie.
Yeah.
There are some pretty raunchy things in the show.
It's just you on your own, though.
It's me on my own, and it's good for people of all ages if you like a twisted sense of humor. It's about it's kind of a bizarre take on perhaps postpartum depression.
Did you have postpartum depression?
I don't believe in the term, but I think I did.
What?
I thought I was kind of curious.
Yeah, no, I was trying to be controversial. I'm like, what? I'm like, really?
What kind of hairspray do you use? And you're like, oh, you're really interested.
No, no, I do want to know.
I know. You're a dad. Of course.
I am. Yes, that's right. Yeah.
It's very hard. It takes your life, even when you're an older lady, such as I am.
You're not an older lady. What are you, like 22 or something?
Well, yeah, I'm 22. to say that, you know, I'm more established. I know what's going on in my life. I actually bought a house. I held down a job. I got on a TV show. And so even so, it was like turning your life completely upside down.
Yeah, yeah.
And nothing can prepare you for that. It's the biggest thing you'll ever do.
Jeffrey's just had a baby, too.
I did.
Congratulations.
Yes. I mean, I didn't. My girlfriend did, and it was awesome. I was there.
Are you getting up in the middle of the night?
Yeah, I help.
You better.
I help. It's hard. I know. But I tell you what I learned is that women are awesome. See that word comes up. Yeah, I mean, it's incredible.
This whole getting the guests to talk to each other, this is awesome. I just sit back. What's it happen? It's terrific. It's like having autopilot.
We'll keep talking. It takes you to the brink, though. It's the sleeping thing that does it, right?
No one tells you about the sleeping thing.
You.
No, the sleep deprivation. I tell you, having children, the caring of young infants, would technically be against the Geneva Convention.
Yeah. Especially the Geneva Convention.
Especially the Geneva Convention. Yeah, they're keeping you awake. And
waterboarding and
waterboarding
having children.
Waterboarding in your face. Yeah.
I called the police on my son. I said, he's in the house. He's trying to kill me. Come get him. Quick. Apparently, they don't pick up infants. They're like, you didn't do anything wrong. I was like, you have no idea.
I'll see, in my mind, I was like, oh, she's onto something.
Yeah.
I'll call the cops.
So, yeah.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah. So.
And then, now what do you guys want to talk about? Ice cream thing. I used to work at Double Rainbow Ice Cream in San Francisco.
Really?
Yeah, it took me back when you were talking about ice cream. I really went to a special place, and I used to eat, like, just craft my ice cream buzz throughout the whole shift, you know? I'd start
craft
with, like...
your buzz?
Yeah.
I really like you, and you are young. Jeffrey, she can come
like
on the
her
trip
too.
To Vegas,
That's
I
awesome.
Think.
Awesome.
Craft an
yes.
ice cream buzz.
Yeah, craft the buzz.
Like
That's
you,
right.
Okay, you might start out with a shake because you want something more like a meal.
All right.
And then you, like, hit it with some coffee ice cream, and then you've gone too far in the heavy ice cream, so you clear the palate with maybe some lemon sorbet or some raspberry sorbet. And then you're ready to get back in there, and you just wait until you crash, and then you keep eating some
This
more.
Is awesome.
Yes, this is very good. This is, I think you might make best mom ever. Yes, it's very, we're actually out of time, but I don't expect you to take any notice of that, because nobody else does. I don't know what to do.
Anyway.
Yeah, I really don't. I mean, CBS are like, please show a commercial. I'm like, why? So, fancy an awkward pause? Three-way awkward
that
pause?
That was good. I was seeing that happen.
Yeah,
I was
all right,
like,
let's try it. Right. What we do here is we sometimes
I know about your awkward pauses.
All right. You ready?
I know.
This is the first time we've tried a three-way, though.
I'm just happy to be part of it.
I'm going
to
hold my ground.
All right, you hold your ground.
Okay.
I'll be sexually ambiguous, and you be lacking in sleep.
Okay.
I get nervous.
Really?
Yeah. I mean,
me.
You were going into a full-on one-man show with not even talking. It was amazing, but I still got nervous. I felt I had to jump in there. Also, I was holding my breath. Which was a really dumb idea.
That was a weird choice.
That's so stupid. Why?
That was
you were holding
choice.
Your breath? That
for
was your choice? Pause.
Yeah.
That's a terrible choice.
You gotta...
Oh.
I wanted to give it something like...
Well, yeah, but holding your
she's
breath...
She's also holding her breath.
But it's better if we can see it, though.
That was a little too...
Yeah,
a little
bit.
That was my problem
yeah.
in life. I just... Yeah.
Anyway, we've got to
always
go
that's, inward that, with
that's
it.
That's it. It's time for commercials.
Okay. Talk to you later.
If you're watching Craig at Home, you're missing half the fun. Consider this your formal invitation to laugh live in our studio audience at a taping of The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson. Please give us a call at 323-570-0059 or visit our website at 1iota.com.
What did we learn on the show tonight, Craig?
The drawing of the cat is fine. Go back and blog about something else. I realized what the problem was. Jeffrey Dean Morgan, Mary Lynn Rajskub,
Craig Ferguson.
It got weird. You know, everybody thinks three ways are going to be great, and then you... But you never think you're going to be the one that's kind of left out a little bit. It was weird when Jeff Peterson was pleasuring himself.